Hello there, I am Chef Manu and this is Chef Kiyoko.
Hello.
We're both from the Sushi School and Sushi-Robots.eu, and today the topic is Onigiri.
Yeah, Onigiri. Do you recognize the word nigiri? Just like that, you know, nigiri sushi?
Mm-hmm.
Basically, it's just the same thing, but different shape. And it is a very, very common lunch food, you know, typical grab-and-go food in Japan, isn't it? When you went to Japan, you're just amazed by the variety.
It's pretty much everywhere. When you go and take the train, on the bus, everywhere, people have and buy onigiri, so you've got onigiri shops. Now, it's traditional in Japan, but it's catching on a lot in Europe. So you've got loads of businesses that we've helped setting up as well in Germany, Belgium, and now it's coming to France and it's hitting the UK as well. It's really traveling down. Onigiri in Japan, for Kiyoko it's okay, for me it's not. It's just not enough fillings. So the onigiri in Japan, you've got a tiny little bit of fillings at the top. So when you buy it, you think, oh cool, I'm gonna have loads. You take the first bite and then it's all rice. So there are lots of different ways of making now onigiri.
But,
do you want to show?
Yeah, but the just bringing us back to the original part,
yeah.
I'll show you, first of all, why onigiri is always, it serves in a triangle shape.
Yes.
And that is because, well, we didn't have a machine to start with.
No.
So onigiri was always made by hand.
Uh-huh.
And when it was made by hand, a bit of rice, so bigger hand, big onigiri.
Okay.
My hand reasonably big, so, you know. So it was always made this way, yeah? And then in the middle, you break it up, and then maybe
put it
in there. And then you cover it as you make it.
Uh-huh.
And then you shape it using the shape of your hand. So that's why it always starts to become a triangle shape. Yeah? So that's the reason why.
It's funny that you call it onigiri. It should be called te-nigiri.
Well,
yeah,
but
it's
just, no,
it's
onigiri, sorry.
Then again, yeah. I don't speak Japanese. Te means hand, just in case.
And then a bit of nori, yeah, it'll go something like that. Nori is a very functional food. It serves as the preservative, so if you completely wrap the onigiri with the nori, your food or your in it rice will last a bit longer. But anyway, so that is a kind of typical onigiri thing. But the problem was that as the moisture from the rice start to get into the nori goes floppy and chewy.
Not cool.
I know. So people started to develop this very, very handy things. So it's the wrapper, onigiri wrapper, which has got the nori, sheet of nori in it. So once it is wrapped like this, all you do is just to pull it up.
It's very clever packaging. Basically, when you open it, you remove the plastic and the nori comes and sticks onto the rice. So it's always fresh. If you do it at 4 o'clock in the morning and sell it at 12 o'clock, will just open it and the nori will be crispy as it should.
And then you just secure the nori like that and then you just eat. Yeah.
Onigiri.
So this is a very, very latest thing. And the problem is, again, if you want to do this as business and make lots of it, hundreds, thousands of it, hand making just would not do the job.
It just takes a lot of time and also compression can be an issue. So there have been different types of machines developed over the years. You have the manual onigiri maker, which acts a bit like as a press, really.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. But it's not as much.
It's not quite efficient.
It's not really efficient. You still spend a lot of time putting the rice in.
And then the fillings in, and then put more rice in, and then the final press down, isn't it?
So there has been, well, there is a machine on the market, which is this one. And this one can make two different things. By swapping the mold, you can make nigiri sushi, which are the small balls, but also onigiri. Now, there are, as I said earlier on, a lot of different types of onigiri. And what I mean is the filling can be at the top, inside, it really depends. So we've got 240 molds to choose from, which obviously you will find what you need in that. And just to show you, these are the molds that have been used to create
this
one. So small onigiri, which is good for, you know, like catering events, or if you are at a trade show and selling like cheapish food like sandwich, that's really good. And here we've put another mold just to show you, and this mold makes a hole in the center. So then you just have to basically go on and do your onigiri. So I'm just going to switch the machine on and let it run, just to show you how it runs. Basically, it's a turntable. So this one was created earlier on, that's why you've got a rice at the bottom. It was the end, up. And then it just carries on. And you pick it up, put your fillings in, and carry on. There is a laser on it, so it knows when it's not there. Now, you can use any types of fillings, and you can use this as well. This is a new product that was developed in France, based with seaweeds, shallots, and lemon. It's by a company called Alga, or Algae, and they sell it straight away like that. And this is just basically seaweed, shallots, and lemon. And you can just have this in your kitchen or for trade shows. And this is really like a nice taste of Japan with the European combination of the shallots. It's really nice. I like it.
And so this is one example, and again, this is another example that we have. Now, this is quite thickish, isn't it?
Yeah.
But depending on the molds that you have, or changing by the mold, you're going to have a much thinner one.
Yeah.
And then you can have two pieces and use it as an onigiri sandwich,
yeah,
which is a really great idea. Yeah. It doesn't happen in Japan as such, but yeah, over here, it's great.
The reason why these molds have been developed with the two halves rather than a big onigiri like this is just for the European market. Because Europeans, when they buy these with just a little bit of filling inside, they might feel like, you know, it's a bit of a ripoff. So they like to have more fillings, and that's why Otek have developed so many different molds for the machine.
But just simply, again, just talking about the variation, simple onigiri shape, and you could, you know,
in furikake,
furikake.
Just drop it.
And presentation-wise, it's nice and colorful. You know, you can do the same thing with a sesame, whatever takes your fancy. Whoops. You know?
It's a great little product. I mean, there is great margin, obviously, for any businesses doing this.
Yeah.
It's a no-brainer. You've got barely no food inside, just rice. As long as your shari is good quality, it's okay. Again, the machine is super easy to clean. Just take it off, and you've got your rollers that are giving the onigiri shape. So again, you've got 240 different sizes you can choose from, and then the rollers. So 1, 2, 3, 4 different sets. Clean it, put it back on, and you can change these with nigiri units as well. So the same machine can make nigiri and onigiri. You choose.
And also another shape that they can do is the log type shapes.
Yes, but that's not really used in Europe, is it?
Okay, but it's very Japanese.
No, it is. How do you call it? Manuchi?
No, makunouchi.
Makunouchi. Is it deep fried sometimes?
No.
No, you just...
No. It's just a rice presentation.
It's like a little rice log. C'est la vie.
Yeah.
Well, we hope we basically covered a lot of things regarding the onigiri.
Ah, just another thing.
Okay.
We get lots of inquiries about onigiri.
Yes.
And one thing that a lot of people ask is about, well, what about buying one of those big machines?
Yes.
You know, for mass production.
Yeah.
It's very, very, very expensive.
Very expensive.
And what it is that with that, because you can't just buy one onigiri shaping machine. To go with that, you've got to have the automatic
wrapping
machine. So together, you're talking about well into €500,000 or something.
Yeah.
So this is the only
mid-market.
Yeah, very efficient. You can do hundreds and hundreds in no time. You know, particularly you can have 2-3 units.
That's
no
right.
Problem. So it's a really useful machine.
And again, this is Otek, and Otek have been really present in Europe. They are one of the best sellers really in Europe, and because they have worked on the rice quality, so it doesn't squash the rice like Italian rice, like other machines would do. That's it?
Yep.
We hope we answered most of your questions. If we haven't, drop us a line, give us a call, go on the website. Yep. And happy onigiri making.
Happy onigiri making. Thank you for watching. Bye.